DuPage, Kane, and Kendall County 4-H has a multi-part bridge building challenge for you, which is inspired by our Bridge Bust event. In this part of the challenge, we want you to build a bridge using plastic building bricks or building systems such as Lego, Mega Bloks, Connex, or Duplo. Then, see how much weight your bridge can hold. You can find complete challenge specifications in the challenge details document on our website at go.illinois.edu/STEM4HDKK. For this challenge, you'll need interlocking building bricks. Use whatever system you have on hand. For ensuring your bridge meets the specifications, you'll need a ruler or tape measure. You'll also need to round up some objects to use for weight to test your bridge, such as books. Lastly, you'll need some painters or masking tape. Your goal is to build a bridge that spans over a space on the ground at least 10 inches wide. To do this, we recommend placing two parallel lines of painters or masking tape on the floor, spaced 10 inches apart to help you plan and test. You'll need to build a bridge that can reach from one piece of tape to the other, with supporting structures either on the tape or outside of it. You also need to keep the following specifications in mind. The bridge cannot have any piers or pillars between the 10-inch space. The bridge should be engineered to hold the load over the gap between the lines of tape without buckling. That means when you place whatever your load is, it should be on the portion of the bridge that is between the 10-inch floor markings, not on the portion that is outside the tape. You may construct your bridge to have pieces that sit below the level of the road surface that you will test on, but none of those pieces should touch the ground. Work with your parents to figure out what objects you may be able to use as weights so that you can design accordingly to accommodate those objects resting on your bridge deck. We find that books make great weights, but to use them, you need to have a nice flat bridge deck. We encourage you to watch our video about bridges and look at pictures of different types of bridges to get ideas for your own creation. You may find that sketching a design in advance may be helpful. Building bricks are great because you can easily put them together in a certain way to test an idea and then take them apart to make adjustments. This is called troubleshooting. Build with your bricks using a measuring device periodically to make sure your bridge will meet the challenge specifications. Once you have your bridge built, you're ready to test it. You should only do testing with parental supervision. You'll test by using heavy objects from your home, like books. We recommend keeping your bridge within 5 inches of the ground when testing to help minimize risk when the bridge eventually breaks. Test your bridge over a durable surface that you are unlikely to damage, like a garage floor. Be sure to stay as far back as possible when placing loads and ensure no body parts or pets are under the bridge deck or close to the bridge. You may want to consider wearing safety goggles. Load the bridge with weights slowly so that you can easily identify the objects it was able to hold before it buckled. Record the maximum load of your bridge by placing the objects it was able to hold on your home scale. If you had fun, challenge yourself to use your observations from your first bridge to make improvements and build a second bridge. In the challenge document on our website, go.illinois.edu/STEM4HDKK, you'll find directions on how you can share your creations with us via email or on social media. We're excited to see your bridges and what they're able to hold. If you have fun with this challenge, consider participating in our yearly Bridge Bust activity, which we host every winter. In this challenge, youth or family teams build bridges using a supplied kit that includes balsa wood and wood glue. We then test the bridges by adding weight until they bust. It's a really fun event, and we've had bridges hold over 70 pounds. Learn more on our website.